Pilot, we'll wait for your confirmation before just dropping you.
Understood.
No, we'll just let me know when you do have it, though.
Copy that. Altimeter's reading 4 meters.
Copy that.
About 3 meters there.
Understood.
I have control of thrusters at this time.
Copy thrusters. Crane's going to knuckle out.
Copy that. I'm going to push forward a little bit.
Yeah, you can probably push just a touch. Yeah, looking good, pilot. You have a good visual there in the port robo.
Yeah.
Great. Okay.
That's good.
Are you happy with that crane orientation?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. I think we're good on the crane, Jared.
I have good eyes and everything, so. Oil is actually naturally occurring in the ocean. Did you know that?
Okay, John, are you good to stay there on the tether? Okay.
Okay, what order did you want to... Oh, yeah. I got so excited, yeah.
You got Fernando on comms?
I do. He's not talking to me at the moment, but I have him latched. Yes. Copy that. All right, we're just going to get serious wet and go from there. Yeah, you turned on my stuff. Yeah.
Hey, Roland, can you move that starboard robo back so I can see Sirius when it goes in the water? Thank you, sir.
Pete's ready when you are. He was nodding to me.
The
James.
Oh, yes. Correct. Yeah, Roland, sounds good. Look at Bobby go.
One-man show.
Those poles. Oh, I'll turn a point. I'm down. I'm coming up. Twenty-two. Yeah. Bullseye. guess what you would yeah. So we could take the angle of the rotator, we know the distance, we can determine. Wow. There's no way to know for sure. Yeah. All right, so it's getting wet. Tomorrow we can swap that piece on the Titan, Sirius Titan. Or, yeah, it's a couple items. We just picked up a second bogey. Closer than last. Yeah, that's nice, huh? What do you think that is? Like a basket, shopping basket. Sirius is wet. Your aft camera just flickered. Right? Thanks. Okay, so it's just a brightness adjustment. It is pretty bright outside.
Okay. Okay. Bobby's saying Sirius is in, so... Winch, I see you're at zero, but you can zero the counter and then pilot. I don't think there's any value in zeroing wraps unless we want to try that.
I could line up, but reverse and do it. Nice. How's that sound?
Wire at zero.
Copy.
I'll zero here.
Looks like your inverse ship there.
Yeah, all right, we're zeroed out. Yeah, it is. Oh, I wasn't.
Okay, A-frame is secure. And winch, let's go ahead and pass winch control to the control room, please.
Oh, hello.
Control room has control.
Great.
Control room confirms control winch.
Yeah, I saw it budge a little. Okay. Well, I think we'll get them going for recovery and get all set up with the tugger. With the bumpers and the hooks. But you guys just keep us updated how things are going, maybe?
Yeah, sounds good.
Okay.
All right. In your list, okay. We're going to start with.
All right. How's the forward lat look? Do some heading changes. See if its current is the same as the other lateral. Was close.
Pilot, sorry to interrupt. I didn't mention the GoPros, but you know where they are and or can see them, right?
I know there's front high.
Yeah, the one that I would be concerned with is if you do anything with the craft, there's one on the starboard rock box.
Oh, I see it. Okay, yeah. Got it.
And then the other one is
I'll practice turning
upper.
It on and off.
Hit the touch screen. The other one is starboard upper swing arm. I think at some point we want to get a good shot with that.
Okay.
And maybe we could talk about recovering with it out, although I'm not sure if that would serve its purpose, but yeah.
Understood.
I'll let you guys do your thing. We'll keep yours on, though.
Roger. I'm going to keep deck A last year. Would you rather have me not talk on deck A?
No, that sounds good.
Okay. Yeah. We got a DVL test with Fernando. I want you to come out of auto heading and give me some harder heading changes, and we want to watch that forward lat.
Copy that. Is my deck have ears? Can they hear me?
John's out there.
Nav, just to follow procedure, I'll give comms back to you, though.
Good copy. Nav's got comms.
Okay.
John, if you can hear me, just give two thumbs up to the camera.
Yeah, he's pointing out.
That's just one thumbs up, though.
Yeah, it's close enough. He only has one thumb. Oh, there's the other one.
Okay.
Sean, can you hear me?
Oh, there
yes,
you
I have you.
Oh, weird. Sorry, it looked like it was latched open, the belt packs kind of acting funny.
Okay.
But I got yours.
Yeah. I mean, those belt packs are they're probably fine. It's probably user error.
Yeah, most likely.
Say, I'm going to do some harder heading changes. Just going to give you a heads up. At any time I'm yanking on the tether or anything like that, let me know.
Roger that. How, what turn degree do you expect to go to?
I'll just do, like, 90-degree turns.
Okay,
I won't
perfect.
Do anything crazy.
I think you got clearance for, yeah, either direction.
Yeah, just going to give you a heads up. All right. I'm out of auto heading. I'm going hard.
RPMs are matching good. Current's matching good.
Oops, I'm going hard the other way.
Yep, good, good, good. Forward lat is looking good. Oh, interesting. So it doesn't, like...
You want to keep going?
Yeah, keep going.
Oh, we're listening.
Oh, good. That's way more fun. All right. That's good, Sean.
It's good.
It's doing good things.
Okay.
All right. Forward lat, I'm calling it good.
Okay.
Drawer rigging, let's bring hydraulics up and drawer in and out.
Copy that.
You got it on that camera right there.
Okay, go for hydraulics.
All right. AP coming on. Increasing RPM of smidgen pigeon. Valve packs enabled. Drawing out. There it comes. Here's the hose. And just, below Tasman. Here we go. We're going to go all the way out. Okay. It's still touching Taz Daddy's. Oh, how's your altitude? So watch your altitude. I'll watch the...
three altitude.
Do we ever move this lock?
Okay.
Here we go. Coming back in. Retracting drawer. Do we or do we not lose
so
lock?
So we were able to, remember?
Look at that. We never lost lock.
2.9. It went 3.3 to 2.9.
It did.
So there's like a half meter differential we kind of saw. But we never lost it, though. So it might get a little less accurate, but just want to do that a couple times.
Exercising drawer. You said I saw a 2.9.
That was just a small blip, though. There was a... That looked fine to me.
This drawer has some serious movement. That rigging looks real nice. It doesn't want to go in there at all. Like,
It's pretty floaty, though, huh?
The hose?
I guess we'll know for sure as we pick D2 up out of the water. We'll see if it...
Yeah. I think that's good.
Yes.
Yeah, we purged most air out of it. I think that's good, John.
Okay.
I mean, it hits the mechanism, and the mechanism pushes it down, right? I mean, you could dispense some more of the hose with the manipulator, but it's hard to see...
Yeah.
So I would just leave it. All right. I'm going to call the drawer rigging good. I'm going to pass it the test. It's time for DVL tests. I think Fernando said we'll look at warehouse 2.
Warehouse 2.
And you got to start doing some moves for him. And
copy that. Let's see. I'm going to talk to Fernando. Mr. Fernando, I think we're ready for DVL testing.
Fernando, you can talk to deck 8, and we'll just hear you on deck 8 because he can't latch you. So we'll just... bridge through deck A.
All right, so in warehouse 2, I'm going to pull up the message.
I'm going to turn hydraulics off.
Every single time.
Hydraulics coming down. Hydraulics disabled. Thank you.
Okay, NRV DVL stat. And then I'm going to graph the three velocities. Okay, there you go. So... the red one is the x-axis. Positive should be going forward. Black one is...
this is red, John.
Yeah,
that's blue. That's black.
Okay.
So he's saying this red one should go positive when you go forward. So
if I go forward
so
now. You,
so maybe like go back to get yourself room, and then go forward to get, you know what I mean?
Right, there you should have gone forward, right?
Yep.
And then right there you're backwards. Going back.
You might have to do bigger moves than that, but yeah.
I don't know.
Those were tiny moves, John.
I can see it, though.
I mean, come on.
Proof of concept has been confirmed.
Give me, like, meters, you know?
All right, Fernando, do you want
velocity?
To start?
Is that meters per second?
Fernando, do you want me to start just kind of center, or do you want me to get to one end?
Like, we're looking at pretty clean data, so that's good.
Yeah.
Just do the same thing to the side. Just don't move forward or backwards.
All right, I'm going.
Hold on. To the to port. So port should be positive.
Port. I'm moving port.
Yep.
Port only.
There you go. Right there. That's clearly.
That's clearly port.
All right, there you go. And then move starboard. Right there you started.
Starboard.
Move starboard.
Come on, give us. You're barely moving.
There you go. Okay, I think
I'm
those
looking
are
at
decimeters.
Three screens here.
So like tenths of a meter or something. I think.
Yeah. It's
all
definitive.
Right, there you go. And then just go down. So when you go down, that should be negative on the blue.
We don't have a ton of slack on the rope.
Okay.
Yeah, I can go down like a meter.
Yeah.
I mean, like with this, I'm pretty sure we'll see something.
All right, I'm going down slow.
Or if go down as far as you feel comfortable, and then just let it go, and we'll rise. So that one should be okay. So right there, you're going.
He's
down.
Going down. He's going down. He's
yep.
going down.
And just come up quickly. I think. I mean, I
once
feel
it
like
goes, yeah. Once it goes tight, then just rock it up.
There you go, and you came back up right there.
And then
that's 2.3, and I'm coming up.
Yeah, I see it right there. You're coming up.
I didn't want to go any further. I was nervous. I was going to get mud.
You know, but I mean, like.
I mean, that looks.
Yeah, I think that looks good. The next thing would be just to engage the autos and verify that each movement is correct.
Copy that.
On
so, do we engage autos at this time?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, auto XY is coming on in 3, 2, 1.
Okay.
Ren.
All right.
I see a little bit of commands going. Do you want to lead me, or do you just want me to start doing commands?
Do whichever you want, and we'll make sure. Maybe do kind of a meter port. Let's do a meter.
All right.
To port.
Meter to port.
Yeah.
Now.
All right.
Okay, that completed.
All right, so it should stop and then do meter to starboard and hopefully it goes back to. I didn't look it up from the beginning, but it was like pretty much under the crane, right? From that camera view?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, so it should go back.
Looks really good. So what rate and speed? So you're trying to go 0.1, and so that's right here, right? So it was trying to get to 0.1,
mm-hmm.
right? I'm assuming meters per second on the Y. And that black is your square wave. That's you trying to. That's your acceleration.
Yeah. So I'll go. I'll come back now. Moving aft.
Yeah. Try to do.
Coming to stern.
Do aft.
Stern 1 meter.
So that should be red negative. Yep. Right. Look at that. That's cool. That looks like really good data. That looks a lot better than we saw in Shakedown. Remember Shakedown?
Yeah.
It was
moving forward.
All right.
Shakedown just made no sense.
Yeah, I agree.
All right, I think that's good. Maybe.
It's also a nice bottom. These are all nice rocks, nice hard return. Like this is a pretty good substrate.
Yeah, okay, that's forward.
Yeah. I don't know how comfortable you feel going down.
I'll go down like, let me put in like decimal 8 meters. Is that okay?
Yeah.
I'm gonna save that.
I'm willing to bet it doesn't have enough D to get past the surface tension. Let's see. He's got 3 meters altitude. It's more of a line issue rolling. See, so he doesn't have much rope.
So I'm going to do, all right.
It'll be fine.
Let's see the altitude's in. Let's see. Fernando, so my altitude autos is great.
You gotta go auto depth. Punch in auto depth. Or out of altitude.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, you should be able
to
just...
My altitude's not in. Let me turn it on.
There you go. He's running altitude mode. So okay. This is off
so
the...
So it kicked... it did something as soon as it kicked on. You see that?
Yeah.
But it looks like it leveled out.
So it's trying to hold this altitude. So if you go
so if
down,
I go down now,
it should go down 0.8 meters. And that's running on altitude. And I believe that's running on the NORTEC data.
Well, this screen just went dark, Fernando.
Hold on.
Yeah.
Warehouse slept on.
So now it's keeping me down.
So it's trying to hold that altitude. So you feels like you're a little buoyant. Do you agree? About 30. That's about right,
there
actually.
There you go. So, I mean, but it went down, and it's holding at, what, our altitude, like 2.5 or whatever?
2.4.
Yeah, 2.4.
Like,
so that's about accurate.
All right, then just come up or let it go.
All right, auto altitude's off.
Yep.
And I'm just going to float up.
And then how about we just turn like 90 degrees, either port to starboard, and do a few moves that way just to verify that everything is fine.
Yeah, sounds good. Okay, I'll go to starboard lateral. Okay, that's about 1 meter to the starboard. I'll do 1 meter to port lateral. Oh, I don't think you're going to be able to get it. Really? Really? Yeah, sounds good. Let me center up, and then I'll go down. Yeah. That's interesting. Okay. All right, I'm going to go down decimal meters. Auto altitude's in. Kicked on. Try this. Yeah. Okay, so I'm it's kind of holding, yeah.
Levi, maybe hold off on turning nav off. They wanted to test the page Andy was just saying.
Okay.
But I think as soon as they're happy with that, I think we should turn it off.
Chris, right. Yeah, once you're satisfied with USBL, then we should probably secure it so we don't injure any small mammals. Is this good enough for a USBL test? Duck test? Right? I mean, it's pretty much doing it. Right?
Yeah, arguably, yeah.
We got two pings, I think it is.
I mean, it's right on the port side there. These updates.
Yeah.
Here, right there.
Do we take a photo?
What's it say for depth? Is it reflecting?
Depth 2 meters.
No,
you're talking to Chris?
17.5. 17.75.
Yeah.
Oh, we could do a
John, there was a request to do a load test. So once we're happy and safe, we'll get you on the surface. I'm talking lights, I'm talking Soyuz, I'm talking like.
Roger that.
Understood. So I'm going to hold like this, correct? In auto depth? Auto altitude? Understood.
Is that Bobby back there on headset too? I know. No.
Yeah, would you like, I can put him on if you want to talk to him about stuff.
No. Does Tim have a headset?
Oh, sweet.
Is that Bobby or Tim back there? That's Bobby. He just doesn't have a headset. Looks like he's looking at Sirius.
Levi, you want me to hand over my headset?
No. You keep looking at D2. You keep staying at headsets. No worries.
Oh, crap. Good. Okay. Great. Five for five. Nice work. I'm going to come out of auto altitude. I'm just going to float up. Could run the craft. Yeah.
Yes.
No, I tested everything, so CTD stuff came back. It was working and stuff.
You see how good the blue view picks up the slope?
Oh, yeah, wow.
That's sweet. It's like, yes, picks up the poles really well.
Oh, yeah.
And you can aim it. Look at that. Yes. Yes. Yes, sir. Yeah, I did. I just did, and now I'm like another 90 different. So I'm going to go ahead. I'll go forward. Okay. Sounds good. I'll do some moves here and let me know when you're happy. That was forward. I'll come back. Okay, that's done being astern. Coming port. Okay, that's all the way port. Now I'm going to go starboard.
It's mini zoost. It's probably just a bubble on the lens for mini zoost.
They said the port manette. Okay. You want to do loads? Okay. Fernando's happy? Yes, sir. Starboard lat turn push down. Yeah. Okay. Sounds good. Yeah. All right. I am out of autos. Deck. Hey, we're gonna do some heavy driving. Advised. Get a little bit to this side. All right, you ready? It's pretty good driving, huh? Do it again. I'm gonna reset.
set.
All right, ready? Yeah, we should fly with Sirius more often. The auto heading got a little wild there for a little. I think it almost hit like a sort of like overcompensating.